coming to the end of February, got a leap year, so one more day, which is always nice for people like me. And hopefully we'll have Eric Lopez on tomorrow night to recap some softball action and get ready for the grand opening of Love's Field on Friday. Isn't that exciting? It's not quite 100% done, but it's just ready enough to host a game. But let's talk some football news, because if you haven't heard or listened, I suggest you check out the Oklahoma Breakdown with Teddy and Gabe. They had a long one-hour interview with Brett Venables, kind of a primer for spring ball. A lot of interesting notes there. The first one I'll get out of the way right now is there's been some rumors about Jacob Lacy about retiring, and he has confirmed that in this interview. He will likely have to retire from football due to blood clots, so really sucks. His most memorable moment for me was actually in the Cotton Bowl. He made a very key sack on that final drive for Texas, or their field goal drive that put them in the lead for Texas. He put a sack that like put a stop to that and likely saved the game. But there's just a list of OU players out there, man, who are known for making just one play, and that was all they really people remember from them. But hopefully Jacob, you know, wish him the best, man. And it sucks you lose a little bit of depth on that D-line, you know, that's sometimes just how things roll, man. You gotta do the best what you can. Gentry Williams won't be taking part in spring, had labrum surgery after the season, so he's still recovering from that. They don't expect Justin Harrington back yet. You haven't even heard back from the NCAA to get that medical waiver for another year. He will likely get it. It'd be really weird if he didn't. I know he's still recovering, and they hope to have him back sometime after spring. And Desaw McCullough missed winter workouts because he had a simple knee scope, so he should be ready for spring ball, according to Brent. So those are kind of the big things, the big news, player news, expect to go into spring ball. And I hope to have, you know, more fun going into March, where we go into spring ball and what to look forward to and all the key battles, because there's just a lot of player battles with linebacker, defensive back, and, you know, the defensive line is going to be interesting to see how things turn out there. You know, obviously, and of course, you want to see how our new star quarterback, Jackson Arnold, is turning out. And, you know, he's got a big wide receiver room to play with. And, of course, the big thing is the offensive line. You know, I feel good about the interior, and Brent will make you feel better about the interior or the way he talks about certain guys. But yeah, it's the tackle spots. You know, Sexton's probably going to get one of those spots. We'll see how the other one goes. I know they brought in the transfer from Michigan State, but I do think they will go out into the portal after spring to try to get one or two more, just to add any competitive depth they can in that spot. So obviously we got big basketball games tonight. OU women got a chance to win the Big 12 championship regular season against Texas. Pretty awesome there. And OU men's on the road against Iowa State, who they beat earlier in the year. And it turned out it was a bigger win than we all assumed. And listen, they got Iowa State tonight. They got Houston in Norman on Saturday. I don't expect them to win either one, but if they magically find a way to win either one, not only is it a big win, it pretty much clinches a spot in the tournament. The one game they will likely should win and need to win is a game against Cincinnati coming up next week. But listen, if OU finds a way to win one of these games this week, they're in the tournament. Despite how I feel, you feel, whatever, they'll have gotten that magical 20th win. And, you know, the Big 12, tough as hell conference this year. It's the last time we have to play in it. Especially, it's weird having Houston in it, but it is what it is. But, yeah, well, softball action this weekend, basketball this weekend. So a lot of fun OU stuff to look forward to. And I'll be around to watch it, and who knows what other crazy things. Maybe we'll have another Javion McCollum, like, buzzer beater. You never know. Crazier things have happened. So with that being said, Boomer Sooner, I will catch y'all later, and enjoy your leap year tomorrow. You've earned it.